Hi everyone, this is Arabdha and thank you for joining us for this chat. Today we have got Brent Xu, who is the founder and CEO of Umee, and he's here to talk to us a little bit more about the company, his background, the new milestones that Umee is about to hit, and more. To start with, Umee is a layer one blockchain built on Cosmos SDK for interoperability and cross-chain solutions. From what I understood from a very basic glance, anyone can put in their crypto assets on the marketplace and earn the passive yield out of it. You can also use the deposits as collateral to further borrow more. Yes, of course, that's a very basic idea that I have. So Brent, over to you to explain and talk to us a bit more on what you're building.
Certainly. Yeah, really, really happy to be here. Umee is a cross-chain DeFi protocol that interconnects between the Cosmos and the Ethereum blockchain. And we're building out a suite of DeFi tools that fit in the broader money Legos ecosystem. Umee is a base layer protocol built on the Cosmos SDK. It runs Tendermint BFT proof of stake ConsenSys. And our overall vision and mission is to rebuild the bond markets or the debt capital markets in crypto or Web3 technology. Some background about me before Umee. I was the head of strategy at Tendermint, the creators of the Cosmos blockchain. There I led strategy for Cosmos for about 2.5 years, helped lead the ecosystem through, a few network upgrades as well as implementing IBC. And before all that, I was an early employee at ConsenSys. So helped build ConsenSys from roughly a 20-person organization to a 1,000-person organization in the early days. Saw a lot of the ups and downs of Ethereum since relatively day one. And before all this, I was a bond trader for over half a decade, specialized in MBS, high yield, and distressed assets in the bond trading world. Some background about Umee: we've raised close to $45 million from investors such as Polychain, Coinbase, ConsenSys invested, Tendermint invested. So everywhere I worked in the past is investing in our future, as well as investment from funds like Jump Trading, GSR, Alameda, IDEO Collabs, as well as the Algorand Foundation. Did a coinless sale, had the largest amount of registrants in coinless history at close to 1 million registrants. And our network is up and running, fully launched. And we're anticipating a few, pretty worthwhile upgrades to the network as we're rebuilding a lot of these debt capital market frameworks and, connecting them all through a very powerful protocol called IBC, which we think is going to be a very important protocol in the crypto ecosystem.
Excellent. That's an insane fundraise. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that information and congratulations. So what are your next milestones? Of course, that makes me wonder that you guys have got big visions. So what are the next plans in line?
Certainly. So, I would categorize them into three main areas. So on the protocol side, we anticipate a few major upgrades. So, adding a native leverage module onto the Cosmos component of Umee or onto the Umee blockchain itself. This is a major protocol upgrade that's going to add additional functionality and allow fast finality, borrowing and lending in the ecosystem. Additional upgrades include CosmWasm, which is a WASM-based a smart contract language onto the Umee blockchain, as well as something called interchain security, which will allow the Umee blockchain to be a hub that other consumer chains can draw security from. So that's on the upgrade side. On the application side, we're looking to add additional functionality in terms of more fixed income related tools, such as creating a yield curve or creating a term structure of interest rates for the rest of the crypto ecosystem. The bond markets need a similar to how protocols, they need a base layer. The bond markets also need a base layer. And the base layer in the bond markets is known as a yield curve or a term structure of interest rates. And so we're building out these applications in the Umee ecosystem. And then the third area is on the infrastructure side. We want to be big supporters of protocol, as I mentioned earlier, IBC. We think that IBC is in many ways the TCP/IP of Web3. And we want to build the infrastructure to help expand that vision.
Right. Well, thank you for sharing all of that. Those are definitely big plans. You touched a lot on IBC and cross-chain ecosystem building. Cross-chain, as you know, has a little bit been under the scanner because of the recent hacks and security issues that we saw. So I definitely want to ask you, what are your thoughts on being a cross-chain solution and how do you deal with the security aspect of it right now?
Certainly. So, you know, we've analyzed a lot of these hacks, ranging from the wormhole hack to Axie Infinity to this recent Nomad bridge. And, you know, what we've determined is that bridges that try to aggregate too much bridge activity between different networks are constantly exposing themselves to many types of security vulnerabilities. And we take security very seriously here. You know, we have, you know, done extensive audits, you know, on our smart contracts and our bridges by, you know, great auditing firms like yourselves. And part of it is definitely exposing the vulnerabilities. Part of it is testing. For example, we implemented the Gravity bridge onto the Umee blockchain, but before making it live, we did extensive tests. So we did an adversarial testnet known as Gravity Wars. Gravity Wars incorporated, you know, our entire validator set and encouraged them to attack the bridge and try to expose vulnerabilities and try to double spend and try to do all the bad things out there. We also got multiple auditing firms to, you know, audit the code. And part of it is just making sure, you know, this bridging works, making sure that the architecture makes sense, making sure that there's not a vulnerability, that, you know, it's not. Part of it is also, you know, ensuring that there's, you know, a distributed validator set that manages the bridge as opposed to, you know, a small cohort of multi-stakeholders. That being said, I do want to highlight that IBC kind of revolutionizes the bridge ecosystem. So instead of actually relying on like a proof of authority group to, you know, act as a multi-sig for a bridge, IBC kind of changes it by making a architecture where instead of relying on some bridge supporters, it actually implements a module directly within the state machine of another blockchain and bridges it that way. And because I think IBC in many ways is a more superior technology, I think that it will eventually take over the bridging ecosystem, not just in Cosmos, but between Cosmos and other blockchains just within the ecosystem.
So you yourself mentioned using multiple auditors and really getting your security vulnerabilities checked out. What is your one piece of advice from a tech point of view to the builders in the cross-chain ecosystems?
I know Andre Cronier coined the term like, you know, test and prod. Like he just encouraged you to just release the code and make it work and, you know, just release it and see what happens. I think that's a horrible idea. I think the key to being safe and secure in this ecosystem is just be very patient, do the audits, do the adversarial test nets, and the quality of the protocol will speak for itself. So patience.
Right. Although understated, that's a great, great advice. Do you also see Compound and Aave as competitors? And if so, then how do you actually differentiate when you go ahead with your vision?
I would say that Compound and Aave are their applications on the Ethereum blockchain. And so, you know, I respect those protocols a lot. I think they're amazing protocols. I'm big fans of the founder, but you know, they're more applications on the Ethereum blockchain. Umee is a blockchain in and of itself. It has its own execution layer. It runs its own ConsenSys. It has its own validator set that, you know, provide Tendermint BFT proof of stake ConsenSys. A lot of people don't know this, but you know, Tendermint BFT proof of stake was built alongside, you know, Algorand's ConsenSys. It was built alongside Avalanche. And in fact, the Ethereum Foundation also reference a lot of Tendermint's BFT proof of stake ConsenSys code as they developed their own ConsenSys in their evolution history when they were developing things like Casper, the friendly finality asset, Casper, corrected by construction, and just what they're doing with ETH 2.0 right now. So, you know, Umee itself is a is a blockchain, and there's a lot of components that can be built on a blockchain. Another thing that I want to point out is that, you know, I'd say that, you know, Compound Aave are focused more on sort of the generalized borrowing and lending platform. Umee, on the other hand, is focused on bringing the bond markets or the debt capital markets to crypto. And I think there's many nuances when you're bringing, you know, a market that large. Umee wants to build some of the foundational tools or some of the, you know, foundational infrastructure, as I mentioned earlier, a term structure of interest rates to crypto, as well as different credit components. So I think that the architecture is different, as well as the product segment that we're targeting is also quite different from those two other protocols.
Right, right. You just also mentioned ETH 2.0, and I'm just really, really curious, what are your thoughts on that? Given that there's so much of attention and traction around that, I would love to hear a bit from you.
We've been waiting for ETH 2.0 for many, many years. When I was at ConsenSys back in 2016, you know, we had, you know, folks at ConsenSys saying, yeah, ETH 2.0, or they called it Serenity at the time. There's talks like, yeah, Serenity is going to happen in 2017, or Serenity is going to happen in about 2 years. Be prepared. And we've been anticipating this for, you know, over 6 years now, anticipating this. And it's very exciting. We do see the potential. I know a lot of traders are, you know, making predictions about ETH 2.0 right now, you know, mm-hmm. anticipating some gains, but, you know, builders like us, we've been anticipating ETH 2.0 for many years, and we've been altering our roadmaps and modifying our architectures in anticipation of this merge. And so we're very excited. We're looking forward to all the new improvements that this is going to, you know, add to the ecosystem, and we can't wait to interconnect and you know, have a very powerful interface to work with.
Right. It's all really exciting, and we're all very much looking forward to ETH 2.0 and what comes out of that. Thank you so much, Brent, for joining us on this chat and being a great support and answering all our curious questions around. Thank you.